John Wick Invitational. It's Savage versus MouseSpaz, formerly Netcode Guides. Very dominant performance by them in the first map as they take Mirage with relative ease against their counterparts, their Canadian counterparts, Savage. But the second map, which is the map chosen by Savage, will be Nuke. And I wonder if Savage can play a really, really strong CT side, start off on the CT side, get a good amount of rounds, and perhaps steal away this map from MouseSpaz.
You just said maybe the most essential part about this second map, which is the CT side. Will they even get to play CT side? Because the terrorist halves on these Americans today has not been that good.
No.
The CT side has been fairly impressive, but the T side has been lacking a lot of structure and set strategies executed on the right timing, because they had set strategies. They just used them slightly wrong, I think.
Yep.
So hopefully it's going to be fixed now. I can really see this going into a massive deficit, no matter what team starts a CT. So it's going to be about the knife round. It's really going to be about the knife round, I think.
I think it's going to be very important. And that's the thing. T-sides on Counter-Strike usually require quite a bit of coordination. If your team doesn't have that coordination, it's going to be very difficult to push through the CT side defense, especially in the North American scene where there's a lot of talent. I mean, there's individual players who can land the shots and you know, they can cause the damage. But as a coordinated team, they're not as efficient as some of the other sides, and that's kind of the main difference between the top teams in the American scene here, is we see a very, very efficient MouseSpaz and a not so efficient Savage here. Knife round on Nuke will be very, very important indeed, as this is a very, very strong, a very, very strongly CT-sided map, sorry, with the advantage going towards whoever starts off on the CT side. And if you get that momentum, he does something quite dodgy, but if they catch him, oh, Haze is gonna go down, but he does damage.
Yeah, but is it enough, though? It's actually still in the favor of MouseSpaz. Oh, actually, it's not anymore, because two guys ain't tagged. One guy ain't tagged.
Oh,
this is a safe win for the Savage team now. This what? Guy can just charge. And he's gonna do that. Doesn't matter if he's gonna get hit, he will always get the revenge. And of course, they're gonna go for the CT side in this situation.
And Savage, now, starting off on the CT side, there's hope for the Canadian team.
You think so?
Yes, they can. If they can string together a large amount of rounds, if they can string together 13 or 14 rounds, then perhaps they can get this map from MouseSpaz. But if they show just a glimmer of weakness, if they give away even 5 or 6 rounds to MouseSpaz, it's going to be an early night for them, and they'll be kicked out of the tournament.
Yeah, for sure.
But they'll go home with $22,500.
So I think they'll
nothing to complain about.
No. This CZ push into the hub is going to get one, and the second one from Hades. They're going all in with these CZs.
There's the aggressive push by Hades, and no support coming in from his teammates. He has to back away, go back, and hold a better position, but he gets a frag on Cutler. An important frag at that as well. He's like a dog caught in the corner with nowhere to go.
But look at the grenades of on FNS. That means that they already had a plan about what to do in this round, and that got destroyed by the aggressive play by the CT. So very nice play, and Glurance is going to finish him off with the USB headshot, and the last kill is going to be made by Cut with the CZ.
Good start for Savage. They've gotten the first round.
One round played, headshot counter says 5. Pretty good.
It's pretty good. About 80%, 70%.
It's about 100% nearly. Did the terrorists get a kill?
Yeah, they got 2
okay,
kills.
Okay, so. God damn it.
I was right, you were wrong.
Yeah, I was completely wrong. I didn't think the terrorists got a kill. I don't know. I think I was leaving for a second. But we have the Swag 7, we have the silenced M4, the unsilenced M4, and the Farmers and CZ.
And we have the Force Bite coming in from the terrorists here on the second round as they push towards outside. They've smoked it off. They might go for a secret push. Tarik with a little cheeky jump down. Cud was ready for him, however, the M4, and the terrorists now are pushing towards the B site. Nobody to contest him. Relics with the rotation coming in from Ramps. He does have the Swag 7, but it's quite a distance. He actually lands a lot of shots on Cutler. Cud has to be careful. Oh, Lord, FNS will get the frag. Hazed actually gets a frag on Relics, and JDM takes down Hades. So it's a 2-on-2 situation here, but no guns picked up yet. Haze coming up from behind. Oh, but Valens sees it. Valens doesn't make any mistakes with the FAMAS.
I wonder if Haze has auto, what is it called? Auto pickup? Auto pickup?
Yes.
Auto pickup? It looked quite weird to pick up with 7. Maybe he was just unlucky, but it looked a bit funny.
Maybe he wanted it.
Maybe he wanted it.
He wanted swag, the swag
7. Save me.
Give me swag, swag 7. Give me the swag you needed to beat MouseSpaz. 2-0, as they've had a relatively solid start, but it's to be expected that when the pistol round, they won the round after that. And now it should be an easy win on the egoing MouseSpaz. But the real test will be the fourth round when MouseSpaz go for a full buy with AK-47. So will MouseSpaz have some tricks under their hat here on Nuke? Or is Nuke perhaps a map that they're not really practiced so well?
That's a good question, and I can't answer that. But we're going to see a T round relying on a one flashbang. So it's going to be interesting to see how Haze is going to use a little turbo to him if we can.
And they look still quite dangerous, you know, MouseSpaz. Even on an eco round like this, they look relatively dangerous. Pushing it to the side, Cut will get one frag. He's going to run out of ammo. Force could change to his USP, and he'll be completely and utterly overtaken by the terrorists. But Valens and Hades, with a very fast rotation to support from heaven and from lower, from outside.
What's a good flash? It created chaos on the napalm side. Isolating one guy on the side, he died, and then the other guy had to cover a lot of guys, and they actually stayed alive for quite a long time. But two kills for the terrorists and the flashbang and some P250s.
Not bad, not bad at all, actually. Exactly. Could have been a lot worse. Savage now with three rounds, but it is a full buy from MouseSpaz. JDM actually able to afford the AWP, not going for armor. Glass cannon set up here from the AWP before MouseSpaz, but does he need the armor?
Ooh, the wallbang.
The wallbang from Cud. Plan. Actually, they do. Oh god, Tarik, he already had quite low HP, but Hades from the other side behind CT red box will be able to get the frag as he shoots down the jumping Tarik. Cud now.
And this is ready the tea house that we have been talking about. It just ain't seen to work because they're going one by one down in secret here. So, once again, no possibility of trading unless Cud is going to make a small mistake.
Cardi should have backed away. He should have stayed in that
5-3 position. 5-3, go passive, my friend. But this time, the terrorists equalize the situation, and they could actually win this if he connects with the guy in heaven. But so far, he's not.
Dangerous here for Savage. They have to be careful. They have to take it easy. They have to choose the bomb site to defend and not split up their forces so much. It's a 3-on-3 situation. They don't want to lose any more men and have the disadvantage. If they still have the three men going in for the retake, it's better than only having one or two. Hazed.
Oh, the push. Well, by Relic. I think he's actually going to die to Haste.
Yeah, Haste has got his AK-47 face right at him. Oof. That was a pinpoint shot, and he pushes into Zyke. Glorin gets two kills, but Haste gets two.
One-on-one.
Picks up the bomb. It's a 1-on-1 now. Valens is on the other side of the map. Well, actually, he's on A site. I thought he was outside, but he's on A site. Knows the bomb's on the B site, and it's going to be a mind game here.
Yeah, and Haste needs to win a round like this. It's just a fact. What is he doing?
Fires through the doors, gives away his position. Molotov's going to be thrown. Is he going to go for the cheeky defuse?
Oh, he shoots. So he knows it's a big.
Oh, he should have. He actually.
Oh, he gets him while being
shot
blind.
Through the flash. Nicely done by Valens, trusting his instincts there, getting that frag and actually getting
nice
the defuse.
One.
But he was unsure. You could see that. I mean, at the beginning, he thought it was a fake. But then when he threw that flash, he went and peeked, knowing that perhaps he's actually defusing the bomb. I mean, if he knew he had a kit, then he would have known that by that time the bomb would have been defused. So I think perhaps he was assuming he didn't have a kit. It was a bit weird, actually, from Haze.
Well, no matter what, I think that the big mistake by Haze in that round was exposing himself by opening the door, because he did have no clue balance about the position.
Where he was, yeah.
So he could just play the time.
Pretty advanced position here by Hades, and he will miss his shot. He'll get start here on ramp. And they could take advantage of that weakness. Glorin's actually in a really nasty position here. Can do a lot of damage. Can take down Tarik. He's checking Boiler. Flash comes in from the other CTs. And the CTs is quite interesting, actually. The CTs have gone for a pretty aggressive control of outside. You don't see that much on the CT side. And sometimes, I mean, the most important thing is either you have outside controlled or you have ramp control. One or the other. And Tarik will steal that kill on Relics. Valens now rotated towards ramps as Hades takes another position. With that AWP. MouseSpaz, happy with that 1-for-1 trade. Now going towards a ramp where they think it will be Haste with an entry frag onto ramps. Make it 3-4. And the CTs knowing they're going towards the beat site now.
And this needs to beat the terrorist first round. Even though we have good rotation from the CTs, they need to win this round.
They're in a really, really, really tough situation. Florence though gets a frag on Cutler with the support of Cud's final bullets. And he's got Hades there in support coming up from behind. Oh, it's a frag from Glorin's. Hades is going to come up. He opens the doors, tricks them, gets their attention, peeks.
The nade is going to finish him off.
It's 2-on-1 now, but they're against Tarek. We've seen him on the clutch.
The clutch
he has been really, really good on the clutch, Tarek, and he can definitely clinch this round. Pops out, gets the frag on Gorins. Only 3 HP left.
He should go for the instant defuse, his low HP.
Hades is checking the wrong vent. He's going to pop out. He's going to get the better of him. Has the advantage of being the person with the angle, and the bomb will be allowed to... well, he didn't have to explode, but the terrorists get there. First round here on Nuke. 4-1. Savage losing that 2v1 situation against Tarek, and as to be expected, such a great player he is.
He's been doing good. Really good. I think he's been important in the clutch rounds. When you can see, winning this round after losing 4 in a row is still going to force the CTs to an equal round. So it's still something about that the other round has been fairly close, and that the economical damage done in the eco round by the terrorists has actually paid off.
Yeah, it's not been a super dominant round by Savage. They've actually lost quite a lot of players in the various rounds that they've played, and in the 4 wins that they've had, they've not been very, very confident wins indeed. Oh, not bad with that P2K. Hades steals a kill over outside near the CT red box.
He's going to get traded, luckily, but it was a very nice double headshot by him. Relic going for the map information, going to tell his teammates that the rest of the terrorist team is outside by yard. And that means that they should close them down towards the B-bomb site now. And I think they are.
Well, they're
one guy on Ram, one guy Vents.
Relic has to be a bit faster. Well, Grimes is here on Vent. If they push Vents, it should be an easy frag for him. We're sorry, CZ and close ranges. Tarek waiting for that flank, knowing that it's going to happen. We'll get the kill.
Really good patience.
By haste, just go for a quick peek to see if he can see a shoulder before pushing through vents, and he will get that frag on Glorin. Some pretty smart play coming in from MouseSpaz. And, you know, evident game sense by these players. They really know what to do.
Yeah, for sure. Like, just baiting out the first bullet from the CZ in the vent, making the CZ hunt for him, and then he has the advantage just waiting in that angle. Great play.
4-2, MouseSpaz now with 2 wins on the T side, only 2 rounds away from Savage, and this is not really the game that Savage want to play, especially on this very, very heavily CT-sided map. Valens, unable to afford an M4, has a 5-7 instead. And I wonder if that can make
if they lose this round, they're probably going to be on another eco, so in case MouseSpaz wins this one, it's going to be 4-4.
And they have to be really, really careful, Savage. As you said, if they lose this round, it'll be 4-4. And it's just not a position you want to be in on Nuke. You've already given away far too many rounds to MouseSpaz. 2 rounds
It looks so bright. Being up 4-0, being in a 5-on-3. But it changed quite quickly.
Barak's been pretty badly hurt. They're going to push towards secret. There is Valens waiting for them, but he's not the player that you really want to have. You want to have a player with a rifle over on towards secret, but he might get 1 or 2 frags. He's unable to. Runs away with his life. Has a Molotov. Actually, nicely done by him. That's the kind of player you want to have. Oh, instead of throwing... Actually, the bomb's going to go down. Instead of throwing his nade, he actually picks up his Molotov. Has a nade. He's going to just completely, like, pepper them with nades. And does quite a bit of damage. Well, actually, no damage. Sorry, Tarek was already hurt early on that round.
Quite interesting that he got out of that position and actually dealt so much damage.
Yep, and it's all of a sudden it's going towards the CT side as Cud gets a frag on towards the A site. Now they've only got 3 men, MouseSpaz.
And this round is of course going to go in favor of Savage. Time runs out in 3, 2, 1, and...
Hades loses his gun anyway. That's 1 frag for MouseSpaz, consolation. But 5-2, Savage now increasing the lead once more, and they just have to keep the momentum going now. Just leave MouseSpaz with just 2 rounds. Make sure you win every single round after this. Make sure you don't lose so many players as well, because you don't want to be forced onto an eco just by losing one round.
Yeah, and this is actually still going to be very important, because this round counts for 2, maybe 3. Both teams is very low on money.
Gideon. Boosted. Misses his shot, however.
He's not been that effective at all, right?
No, he's not had that major effect for his team, I think, with the AWP.
Also, Nuke can be a hard map to AWP on, but on Mirage, I've been watching his stream sometimes, and some previous games he's been quite effective, So I expected a bit more from him.
He's one of the better AWPers in the NA scene.
Yeah, exactly.
Flashed into the ones the A site. They're coming in from both Squeezy and Blue Hut. CT's back away. They are smoked off. Nicely done by Glorence. Hades gets the kill on Cutler as well. But Tarik again, once more being the thorn in Savage's backside. Valens will return the favor with a quick double. JDM gets two frags as well with the AWP. It's actually a two-on-one situation due to that. The bomb is down. And that was not the cleverest of smokes. He picks up the bomb in Blue Hut.
But, he has the bomb.
Yeah.
He fakes a run onto ramp, but it seems that the CTs is just ice cold. They're just going to wait him out here.
Ice cold.
Ice cold.
They read that.
And let's see if one of them is going to drop to Vents, because that could give a free kill for JDM.
Poker face here by the CTs.
Yeah. They're playing it clever, playing it together so they can retake it in case he goes for the B-bomb side. Is he out, Squeaky?
Oh, he's gone towards the B-site, and that's a bomb plant that he does not deserve. Really nicely done by him to get the bomb plant and boost their economy.
One thing is
if
he went through ramp, but he didn't.
He went through Squeaky. Yeah. I think Lawrence should have definitely got him. He did have the angle to see him go down from Squeaky towards Vent, sorry. But sadly, he wasn't able. Maybe he didn't see him. Maybe his angle was a bit too acute.
I think JDM just wasn't the right timing when they tried to rotate to new positions or something. Yeah. It's kind of weird.
Sometimes luck is all you need.
Or just great timing. Or maybe even wall hack.
don't do it. Don't open that can of worms.
people will go nuts.
People can say wall hacks. Not a bad shot by Hades. Actually going through that iron bar in front of him to take down Cutler. It was a nice flick shot as well, Cud with another kill to make it 5-3. But it is a eco bash by the CT's Cud with a triple kill. Oh, you don't want that to happen. You really don't. Not on an eco round. Hayes with two kills. Can he make it three with the CZ? Almost three kills. Hurting their economy, especially when they were put in such a bad position by having one loss and then not being able to go for a bye due to the fact that they were losing so many players on these rounds. And on an eco, losing two players like that, it should not happen. 7-2, Savage now, 5 rounds ahead of MouseSpaz, regaining control of the match, but only slightly.
Yeah. You are completely right. 7-2, once again, the CT sides of the Americans is just shining. Or actually, Canadian. I do not know if they want to be called. There was a new one in the east of the C25, but let's see here, it's going to be the A push, it's going to be Glorins with his spray down.
Oh, he's been an absolute delight today with the M4. Some really nice skills.
Yeah, he's
by
actually
him.
Been, I don't know, maybe in this matchup he's been the, I don't know, biggest impact guy.
I think, I mean, he got an ace.
Yeah, in this, yeah,
and
he did.
And on Mirage, so.
He's just aiming extremely well, I think.
11 kills for him so far.
Yeah.
His aim's been on point, and he's had some pretty smart plays as well. But is it going to be the difference for Savage? Do they need more from the rest of their teammates?
Maybe, yeah. Maybe not.
I haven't seen so much from Relics so far, I think.
I've seen a lot of you guys in the chat betting for teams in this matchup today, and I don't actually know who's favored in the chat, so try and give me a hint. Is it MouseSpaz or is it Savage? Nice kill here by Relic. Is he gonna throw a smoke?
I think he heard me. I think he heard me make fun of him. Like, not me. I'm actually better than that. Gets that frag on ramp and then backs away, doing the right thing as a CT. This force bite. It's actually a force bite by MouseSpaz. They've got some armor.
Yeah.
Lawrence checks the wrong angle at the wrong time. And Tarik will steal that frag and pick up an AK-47. And he'll use the weapon of Lawrence to kill his teammates.
We have the majority of the people going for MouseSpaz. They are also the heavy favorites on CSGO Lounge. So no big surprise, people bidding their skins on that team.
Yes.
MouseSpaz looking, not MouseSpaz, but Savage looking pretty good right now. So maybe the guys are starting to get a bit worried about their skins. I don't know the feeling.
I don't know. I think that they're winning the rounds, but barely. And you know, you've got Tarik and JDM just running around with CZs, killing players, keeping weapons. They just don't look so confident. And I don't think they're going to be able to win any rounds on the T side. I really don't.
Yeah.
8-2. Now, 9-2 as the timer runs out. JDM able to save that AK-47 for his team. And for a nice full bite and have all the weapons that they need. Will they get for? Will they get an op? I think Hayes can buy an op for JDM, can't he?
Could, and he's going to do that.
That's what he'll do. See, I can read minds.
You can, but then again, JDM sitting with 5 kills, and it's not like kills is the biggest factor of if you're playing well or not, but he's just really not been getting the entry kills. I think he's working too slow out in yard. Also, this time you can see the yard area that they're smoking off, which means that he's going to have less of a chance of actually getting an entry. He's sneaking into the hut area once again. He's going to go for the kill, but quite questionable that he's ever going to win a situation where the CT has a high ground advantage.
It's pretty ballsy play coming in from Hayes there, trying to push no flashes and no nothing, and just trying to get the angles and get the better of the CTs as he pushes into the side. Another thing, JDM, perhaps he's a better offer on the CT side than he is on the T side, because so far he's not been really that excellent with that aggressive pushes with the AWP, leading the way with the AWP. He's not provided much, but maybe his form is just not on point so far. But Savage now, 7 rounds ahead of MouseSpaz. But this time round, MouseSpaz, they're not in a bad position at all. They've gotten control of ramp. They do have one man outside who can come in for a flank. And they can push towards the A site now. They can push towards the B site. They can really, really keep the CTs guessing, who so far have no idea where they are. Hades surviving, but actually that's landing a shot as well.
Through the wall or something.
For FNS is on 3 HP.
Now let's see if they have a nice execute for the B-bomb side. One guy is hiding behind the silo on the side, so he's most likely going to get a kill onto the bomb planter. Let's see.
Lucky by Kud actually puts Cutler down.
Still behind the side. He gets one kill now, I think.
Oh, unlucky there. Hades actually gets the kill on JDM, even though he landed the shot and bomb's
Terek
planted.
Surely can't do this again.
Oh, the bomb. Actually, he survives that. I have no idea what happened. He gets the first frag. Can he get the second? This would be ridiculous here. Glorin is right in front of him. 1-1-1. But Glorin only needed one bullet. Glorin's only needed one bullet on Terek.
I would start to cry if he was going to win that round with that amount of HP.
He'd be the American Clutch Master. He'd be the new Hiko, I think, if had he done that. 10-2, Savage now 8 rounds ahead of MouseSpaz, the kind of score that you'd expect them to have on the CT side, and it seems likely that maybe they can steal this map off MouseSpaz.
Do you think so?
Yeah, if they can get 13 rounds.
If you were going to bet $50 right now and you knew that the score was 10-2, who would you bet on?
Savage. Okay. Just for this map, of course.
Yeah.
Hades.
Winning the battle against JDM with the AWP once again, so...
Double AWP actually here, Relic's picking up the AWP.
That's interesting on CT Nuke, because if they do some kind of execute, it can be really hard to go for the retake with the AWPs.
I don't think they expected Taric picking up the AWP for his team this time around. Picking up JDM's fallen AWP. Now it's 2 AWPs and 2 M4s, not a lot of maneuverability here for the CTs. Valent picking up a kill outside as he pushes towards... that position and takes Tarek's unaware, and now the terrorist up inside late. Molotov, the bomb will go down. Glorin's is.
Look at this guy, he's actually playing extremely well on this side, using the angles for perfection.
And some nice spray downs as well. That control with the M4 has been sublime. Both me and Gideon reading the Twitch chat together at the same time.
Yeah.
Very, very tired. Long day for us, actually. For those, most of you who are in America watching this game, we're in Europe, so it's actually 6 a.m. And we've been up since 6 a.m. Yesterday, so it's
both
been 24
me and Avila has been up for 24 hours now.
But all face it, in the last few days, have been up for like 24, 40 hours.
We shouldn't complain, we're not the only ones.
Yeah, I think we're the least tired out of everyone here. Yeah. But big thank you to everyone involved in with face it, with this tournament, and with the face it land as well. They've done an excellent job with organization of this tournament, allowing these teams to have these tournaments to play and to have this money to play for, and really helping develop the Counter-Strike global offensive scene. 12-2, last round of the first half.
For people tuning in, you might want to give a small introduction to why we have this tournament today.
Oh yeah, for those who have just joined us, this is the John Wick's Invitational. We're creating this tournament to promote the new film that is starred by Keanu Reeves. It'll come out tomorrow. It's about a crazy man who starts killing everybody because his puppy was killed by somebody. And it was a puppy given to him by his late girlfriend. So it seems really, really interesting. It's nice to see Keanu Reeves making movies again. And the trailer has definitely made me salivate. So I'm looking forward to watching that when I get back to wherever I come from.
And it's a 5-on-5 situation, and the game controlled over the ramp area, but the CTs just didn't really care about that area, because you're not going to win the round by having ramp. You see that time over and time again, but it's going to be the A-push. They're going to go directly for the A-bomb side.
Savage really, really need this round. Lawrence has to really rise up to the occasion here, but he's unable to. Only gets one frag spot, being shot down by Cutler there. Cut, shot from behind. FNS with a double kill, and MouseSpaz in the final round of the first half will steal a round and make it 12-3, unless Relics pulls a miracle out of his backside. It seems too likely as FNS will secure that round with a nice triple kill. 12-3. Savage have done their best. They've gotten 12 rounds. If they win the pistol round, then they have a really, really strong chance in winning this map. But if not, it could be a really, really long, really, really long round, a really, really long map for Savage, as MouseSpaz will slowly but surely equalize the score. We'll have a quick 1.5 minute break before we start off the second half of this map. So don't go anywhere. I made a mistake. It was a 1.5 minute break, but not a break for any ads. So you'll be listening to the wonderful voices of both me and Cadian as we wait for the second half to start. And what's happening now? Are we getting more? Yes, we're getting more crap talk.
More crap talk?
Yes.
Is that a possibility at this stage?
I don't know. Very feisty players.
Anyways, yes. Should this go to the third map, it's going to be Inferno, right?
Yes. Should be an easy game for MouseSpaz.
And Inferno is in some way easier for the best teams to shine at, I think. Yep. That's also why it's being played so much in the major events, because especially in the previous major events, such as DreamHack Windsor and EMS Katowice, because it's just a map where it's very balanced. It doesn't really matter that much if you start CT or T. Yes, the CT side is favored, but you have possibilities of countering that with a very good T side and a good strategy. So teams like to play that, because normally you don't really feel like you're getting locked down on terrorists. You always feel like you can change something for your advantage. So that map is going to be interesting in case we're going to go for a third map. But first, let's see how it's going to end in the second half of the second map.
Let's see if my 50 bucks bet is will pay off. And I hope that Savage do play a strong T side. I mean, they only need 4 rounds on the T side. MouseSpaz were unable to get that. So, especially knowing that Savage have had a weaker T side in the map that they just played, Mirage, I do expect them not to do as well as MouseSpaz on the T side. But here, Barrett in a pretty advanced position. But gets a few shots down and pulls back away. It's actually a fake, as you said. They get caught around here, but they will be they will have FNS waiting for them with their CZ. And he backs away. Stays alive. Right move.
They get the ramp, but they don't have any smokes. So it's going to be difficult to get a safe bump up here.
It's not bad. Hades actually gets the entry frag. Cut takes down FNS. This is a good start here for the terrorists. They probably will be able to get the bomb planted over the B-side. Cut coming up from behind with the flank with the Glock. Does a great job of getting yet another kill on JDM, but will be finished off here by Cutler. As Cutler makes it a 2-on-2 situation. Can he make it a 2-on-1? Relics is right in front of him. It's a 1-on-1 here near the secret. Right, but the CTs will get the better now. It's up to Hades. Bomb's not been planted. Bomb's actually dropped. 37 seconds left on the clock. He picks up a CZ, has only 10 bullets. Has to be really careful. The CTs have done an excellent job of both looking down at the same angle at the same time.
And comeback is real.
MouseSpaz now with the pistol round, so they've given themselves room to breathe. It won't be an early night. Well, it wouldn't be an early night, but it won't be an early map for or an easy map for Savage. Instead, I think it's going to be a long, long war. You know, World War One trench war style.
I think so as well.
Yeah, they will surely and slowly come back to control. But it was actually not a bad T side. Oh, Hayes, one shot, the CZ.
They could lose this one.
Lawrence takes down Hayes, but is unable to finish off FNS, who backs away with his MP9. Barely. JDM, though, rising up to the occasion to get a double kill outside, and that Swag 7 put to good use to drop that bomb on the A site of this map. Relics, the remaining player for Savage, will probably be finished.
Just forget what I said about that. They could lose that round. Of course, they could. Obvious. It's obvious.
Tis obvious, sir. Tis obvious indeed.
But one more eco round for the terrorist side here. So it's going to be 12 to 6. And actually we saw Denial coming back from that against SKDC. They were behind 13 to 6 and they came back. So it is possible, especially on a CT-sided map.
I think Savage will really show us whether they're able to come back out of this on the bye round. If they're able to win a round, win that round, win the bye round, perhaps they can come back. Not come back, but perhaps they can finish off this game. But if they don't do that, then I think MouseSpaz have a really strong chance in coming back against Savage.
For sure. 1-on-3 makes it a 1-on-2.
Doesn't have much to play with, only an MP9 that he picked up. Pretty rudimentary weapon in this kind of situation.
It's just mean to give him a weapon like that. You can see he's also going to use MP9 is so useless, especially against Kevlar. I think you need to hit them 11 times in the chest or something with that weapon.
Yeah.
This is fucked up.
Why bother? Why even try? Better off using the P250. Full armor and AK buy now by Savage. 12 to 6, MouseSpaz have won every single round in the second half so far against Savage. But now's the real test here. Will they have any tricks up their sleeves? I mean, this is the map they wanted to play, so they must be able to provide something.
They should be. They should be well prepared on this terror side.
FNS.
With the smoke, I think.
Wall bang on Hades actually puts him down to 55 HP. JDM waiting for him. Misses the shot. Was unsure whether he should fire or whether he should let him go through, but they are able to push through towards secret. Is there actually anybody there to stop them from going in towards the B site? Yes, there is. That will be... I think it's Hazed. Waiting in position. They've also got one terrorist over on ramp. That's Relics. Oh, he gets an entry frag actually, but there are three CTs. And he survives somehow. Have no idea. Throws down the flash and with 15 HP gets away from the CTs and... he's going to be very, very stubborn indeed and try to push in towards A site solo. Maybe he was trying to smoke off the A site to allow his friends to push in from heaven, but Hades now will support his teammates.
If he kills, gets the kill onto Cuddler, it's going to change the whole situation for the terrorist side. But he won't. The whole thing about that strategy was that the CTs counteracted the way that the terrorist strategy executed that round perfectly. And even if he's going to get a... Nah, he's not going to get the round. Because the thing is about Nuke CT with the rotations is you can let go of Yard, you can let go of Ramp, but you can't let go of both Ramp and the long exit at the same time because that is going to gain them the whole B bump side, all the ways to enter that bump side. But if you give them long and you lock down ramp, you're gonna guarantee in several positions where the terrorist is gonna be at. So by that means you're gonna have a way better chance of winning the round. So the rule is just not to give away both ramp and outside.
Yeah, that was a perfect example of MouseSpaz doing that, giving away outside and then making sure they had ramp under control with three men. They are pushing towards ramp here. Cutler's ready for them. Should be an easy anti-eco bash, but he gets flashed, forced to back away, throws down that nade, does a bit of damage on Cut and Valence, but not enough. He is having to need the support from his teammates. They overpower him by numbers. Just goes down on the site. They can get a bomb plant. If they charge, Cutler get the kill and force themselves into the site. They have one more smoke.
But
on
they're
Gorin.
Gonna go back. No way this is gonna work.
FNS is ready for them. He gets the first frag. Gets the second. Gets the third. Easy peasy for the MouseSpaz player. Gorin has no chance. 12 to 8. MouseSpaz now only four rounds away from Savage, and I think my 50 buck bet is just thrown down the drain here.
This is looking to be a very interesting game because MouseSpaz could do this, but for the first time in the terrorist half, Hades actually has an AWP. And is he going to make more work out of that one on the T side than JDM did? That is
he said it himself, it's quite difficult to play with the AWP on the T side.
For some people.
Mm-hmm. Cheeky smile from Kalian.
Yeah, well, I mean, it really depends not only on the talent of the AWP, but also on the composition of the team. How are they gonna let him play? How much spaces are they gonna how much space are they gonna give him? Not only that, but also just what kind of strategic plan are you having for the round?
Well, that's about so far. Excuse me. They've done an excellent job on the CT side, but they've lost a few players in the round, and I mean their economy is not completely overpowering the terrorist economy. They've been damaged almost every round, ever so slightly, but enough to keep them off balance. FNS with a frag on Valance. Cutler was ramp once more. He hasn't been landing his shots. I mean, he's done a good job of backing away and staying alive, but those first shots and ramp have just not worked out for him, and it's given the terrorist confidence to push ramp again and again.
Yeah, exactly. And it's going to be a flawless round. The bomb is in the bag of lobby, and let's see if he's going to try to pick that up. He got it now. 1-on-5 situation for Kurt. Surely can't do this.
He gets the final card. Finished off by JDM. 12-9. MouseSpaz now only 3 rounds away from Savage.
So, this is the second map of the second semi-final, and MouseSpaz, with a potential comeback, is looking to close this match down with a 2-0 series.
It's to be expected. I mean, even with 12 rounds on the CT side, it's not enough if you can't win any T round. You know, if you're unable to win even one terrorist round, then no matter how much you get, even if you get 15, it's not enough.
Nope.
It's not enough. And it's really showing that weak T side from Savage and SK CD is really, really, really showing. SK DC kicked out by Denal. I mean, they went home with $2,500 and the loser of this match will go home with $2,500. And it seems like the loser might be Savage if they keep up this poor T-sided performance on their own behalf.
An extremely nice play coming from the CT side, countering the terrorist play here by double stacking long exit here. 2 kills from Tarek and 2 kills by JDM.
Tarek makes it 3, 12-10. They're 2 rounds away. They're 6 rounds away from securing their position in the finals. That means a minimum payout of $5,000, can be $10,000 if they win the tournament. Not bad.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Have you ever seen that not bad meme?
No.
That face. You've not seen it? That cartoon face where it says not bad.
No? It's funny?
Not funny, but it's a really like, it's a not bad face, you know, like when you say not bad, it's the face everybody makes.
Okay.
I thought you would
have. Like, not bad?
Like.
Okay.
I think there's an Obama one, and there's a basketball player one. Can you go around
there
here?
There should be a Vela one as well.
There are loads of Vela memes. There are.
Why?
Google Vela memes.
Are they good?
No, they really won't make sense because they're about something else. But there are Vela memes.
Okay, I'm gonna search that.
Your phone's on the table.
Yeah, I was just scared that it was mine. Did you hear that?
The ring. Yeah, no, it wasn't you. It wasn't you.
Oh, it would just be so typical, you know. But then again, why would I have an alarm for 6 a.m. or something?
Wake up for school, right?
No.
When do you wake up for school then?
7.
7, okay. I have no idea. I'm out of ideas. Very
but this may be the age we should get back into the game because it's going to get very tense.
Haze gets 2. Tarek with 1 on Hades. Relics, 1 consolation kill, but he'll probably be finished off relatively soon here as JDM will make short work of the last Savage plays. 12-12. MouseSpaz has done it. They've equalized. They've made it to the score that Savage has. And now it's a short sprint to the finish line. 4 more rounds for both sides. Can we see a comeback from Savage, or is it going to be complete utter domination by MouseSpaz as they secure themselves 13 rounds in a row on the CT side? It would be pretty bad indeed, but it is what might be the most likely, as they're just not able to provide the same T side that MouseSpaz did, and they really, really are providing a pretty weak set of strategies. And the thing is, they've been close a few rounds. They've been close a few rounds. I mean, they could have picked up 1 or 2 rounds, minimally, with their T-side performance, Savage, but sometimes luck doesn't go your way, sometimes they land their shots, you don't land your shots, and you end up
Oh, the Mali. They're not burning in there.
Relics, but he defuses the smoke.
Hades, yeah. He
nice
sneaked
flank.
Yeah, he sneaked through the smoke in warehouse. Play by play by him. This could actually be the first round for Savage because they're going to gain a lot of map control. They got ramped now, they got under heaven, and they also got the entry kill, so big possibilities here. They also have some smokes to work with, but one of the two smokes they have is on Glorence, and he's in lobby, so he's going to be useless.
He has to be careful. That's spot his teammate.
Oh, the big rotation coming in from the TTs, and they're just going to lock down this ramp push.
Had one man.
One guy coming in the vent, but he's gonna get the first. Is he gonna go for one? It's gonna be a one on one now. But
Lawrence,
no.
Almost.
So
winning
close
that
to the
1v3 clutch. Again,
God
Lawrence performing
damn.
Pretty good indeed, yeah. But JDM got that frag.
It looked kind of like a fail when he was on the head of that guy in the vent.
Yeah, it took a bit too long to get that frag, yeah.
But indeed. He managed to get the second one.
He got the second one. Nicely done by him. Good crouch spray down. But I was just about to say that push. Two guys from vent, one from lower, completely shut down that pushing for the B-side. It just took too long, and they're able to pick them off. And their aim is just a bit better.
Yeah.
A bit more, a bit better than Savage's. They're able to land those shots more consistently, and more accurately, and faster as well.
Yeah, exactly. I love that X-ray just watching through the smoke on each other. It looks so weird without the X-ray, right?
I don't know. It really sucks when you play CS:GO without X-ray.
Yeah, right? I hate when I go into a matchmaking and I don't have X-ray.
I've got a brain X-ray. I've got game sense. It gives me X-ray. I can guess where they are.
It's going to be 14 to 12. MouseSpaz, are they going to close down this CT half without giving away any single T-round to the Savage team?
What do you think?
I think it would be a sad way to leave the tournament in their whole half without getting a single round.
I mean,
that's 11 in a row. Is it going to be 13 round slots in a row? That's a huge disaster.
And both Canadian teams out of the tournament as well.
God damn it.
That would be nice. We want to see one of the maple syrup.
The aggressive quick scope here. He's going to get the second one.
That's the JDM we'd like to see. Two nice kills by him, but got a bit too greedy and was shot down by a relic. Tarek. He'll finish off his greed. Yeah, they'll be punished for that. Now it's a 2-on-3 situation. Could have been a nice 4-on-2 had he, or even a 4-on-3 had he backed away.
Oh, but the position by Haste.
Haste has been loving those flanks.
Yeah, he's been really good with that. Great game sense.
Movement as well.
We're just gonna let him talk for himself because he's gonna make this an easy killing. Waits the patience.
Oh, poker from Haze there.
One shot.
No mistakes. No prisoners are taken today by MouseSpaz. No mercy whatsoever. 15 to 12 as they've completely whitewashed the Savage side on the second half. And they've just plowed them. They've plowed them every single round. I mean, how many rounds is that in the row? 13 rounds? Now it's going to be 14? Oh, 12. It'll
and
be 13.
This is going to be 13. So, yeah, you can just handle me the $50 when the can is live on us. Or you don't feel like it?
Luckily, it was a hypothetical bet, not a real one. Or else I would owe you $50.
Who are you to decide that? I mean, what is this guy doing?
Then you just want to end it now, Buzz.
Yeah, but it's not the right time to end it when it's 15 to 12. You can do stuff like that if it's 15 to 7.
They're just really overconfident right now. I mean, when you win 12 rounds in a row, you just think, right, I can do whatever I want, really. These guys are not going to do much.
That's true, but it's not going to require much for the comeback to be realized. You need to take care of that kind of stuff.
Actually, they're pushing into the site. Molotov comes down on the site, but nobody's there. Relics missing his shot. Backs away to try and take down FNS, and FNS will take him down. But he's only got 6 HP, FNS, after surviving that firefight. And Lorenz and Cud, remaining terrorists, is very capable of them to win this round. JDM doesn't have a lot of HP after being shot down by Cud. And if Lorenz is able to get caught, then it can be a different story here. Lorenz is now in a 1v1 situation after being a winner, 1v3 clutch, and he does clutch that. Lorenz makes the call, makes the score 15 to 13. But the economy of the MouseSpaz is too strong. You think?
Yeah, I think so. I don't care about that. It's not his team winning. I really
26
think he's
kills.
Yeah, I think he's been the best player on the server. Simply, at least he's
almost
been
top fragging.
Yeah, at least he's been the one shining the most, right?
Yeah, like I mean, you can, you can, he makes a big difference.
Yeah,
him and Tarek.
Yeah,
him and Tarek have played really well.
But I've never seen his name before, so I'll go for him.
I love that. I love to see new players that I've not seen before.
Exactly, and potentially he's been good for some time, but we hadn't had the chance to actually see him. So thank God for this tournament, showing us that there's very talented American players out there who hasn't been spotted yet.
Yeah, exactly. It's a bright future for the scene, I guess. It's a very, very bright future to have these kind of players of this caliber who are able to really, really play nice and big. But 15-13, I mean, Savage can take it to overtime if they play clever. They've got a full buy here. Galil on Valens. And Tarek has got a brilliant balance position here to smoke. Easy kill for Tarek. He pulls back as support by FNS. He gets the double kill. The help that he gets shot down, and it's 16-13 as MouseSpaz will go on to the finals. They've secured their position in the finals, secured $5,000, but tough luck for their counterparts, who go home with a nice 2.5k. Savage beating Area 51,
pretty solid,
doing the unexpected. Play a pretty solid CT side, but they just lack something on the T side, and that's the something that they have to try and improve and try and perfect to come back stronger and come back more successful in the future. The Canadian side, however, losing to the favorites.
I see what you did there.
Oh, the Canadian side, ha ha. The Canadian side.
No, but everyone is doing like the worst joke ever. Canadian, like people try to troll me with that, and they think that it hurts me deep inside, but. Doesn't really. It's just a bad joke. Even my in real life friends tell me, Canadian, come play matchmaking with me.
Can you do a Canadian accent though?
No.
No?
No.
Oh, I would have liked to see you do a Canadian accent. I can do an American one, but not a Canadian one. It's a bit different. Okay. Not a Canadian one. But yeah, it's been a very, very, very nice evening in America, but here it's been a nice morning and a nice night.
John Wick
is released
the movie.
Tomorrow.
It's released tomorrow.
Keanu Reeves, he just looks too sick.
Go watch it. You think this has been entertaining? Go watch John Wick.
I wish I could watch it tomorrow, but I'll be busy casting the finals of this tournament. MouseSpaz versus...
Denial,
sorry, my memory is really kind of hurting because... Well, being awake for 24 hours, your brain cells begin to kind of break down.
Yeah.
But it'll be a very, very interesting final. And it's the two strong teams that we expected to be.
Tomorrow is going to be grand final of this tournament. Go in and place your bets, your winnings. If you lost, go in and just beg your friends to give you skin so that you can bet on this final. Because, no, but simply, it just gets way more entertaining to watch a game if you have skins. On the board,
beg
right?
From your friends to bet on the skin. They
please give me that
great,
creek.
Great.
Give me the orc, the 0.04 cent orc. Give it.
But you're not going to win much. It's going to be like a 60-40 bet anyway. We'll quickly check the brackets for you guys so you can see the results of today and the final, which will be MouseSpaz versus Denial. There, MouseSpaz beating TMP 2-0. Area 51 losing to Savage in a best of three. SKD beat Elevate. We didn't expect that, but they ended up losing to Denial. So the grand final tomorrow will be MouseSpaz versus Denial. Very, very interesting grand final. The two strongest NA teams other than Cloud9 and iBuyPower will be duking it out in a best of three at 2:30 a.m. So 2:30 a.m. CEST, which is, I believe, 7:30 or 6:30, if I'm wrong, in America time, CDT.
I have no clue, man.
Really. The time zones, they break my brain.
Yeah.
But 2:30
at the
CET.
Same time we started today, we're going to start
tomorrow
with the final.
Yes.
So you better be ready there, guys.
And also, Face It LAN is starting. The Face It LAN finals are starting in about 3 hours. So
in 3 hours, 2 hours and 50 minutes. You better stay tuned because that
you'll
is
be casting.
Yeah, not there. First at something like 1, so I can get some sleep.
Really?
Yeah. Roald, shout out to Roald from Face It for giving me some sleep. Love you, man. Much appreciated.
I'll be doing the second stream from 9, so I'm gonna try and get a bit of a nap. But if you've just woken up, good morning. So do check out if you're gonna go to bed.